be not a stop. Watch shit don't never stop. This the flow that got the block hot. Shit got super hot. Ay, give me my respect. Give me my respect. I just took it left like on ambidex. Bitch, I move.
It's just at quarterback HD. See if we can get that to focus. So at quarterback HD, simple. Follow me, you know, DM me whatever question you have. I answer my DMs. I try to do a good job of doing that. So I posted a picture on June 9th saying to give me Q&A questions. Got a lot of them. I think I have about 80-something. And we are going to hop right into this. But I want to say one thing. I'm doing shout-outs now. If you guys want to shout-out, post an Instagram video of you working out, doing football drills, whatever, and put the hashtag SummerGrindHD and tag me, and I'll repost it on my Instagram. And you'll get a shout-out and hopefully get some coaches interested in you. And hopefully it'll help you out. And I always try to work a lot on the summer because it's where you get your most improvement because it's just you and football. There's no like schoolwork you gotta worry about, stuff like that. So summer's very important and I wanna reward the people that are working out, doing what they can to get better for the next season during the summer. All right, so first question is, I get this a lot. Wouldn't say I like this question because I like things the way they are. It is, do you play any other position except for quarterback? Go in my eighth grade year, I played tight end a little bit. So I do kind of play another position. What school would be your dream school to go for college? I grew up a really big Virginia Tech fan. So I guess Virginia Tech would be my dream school. But I will go to any D1 college that offers me a scholarship. Or I prefer walk-on or something like that. And wherever I can play football, that'll be my dream school. Because that's been my dream for my whole life, is to play college football. So whoever can offer me that would be great. And yeah, really any school would be my dream school if they can allow me to play football. Are you going to do another What's in Your Bag video? I am thinking about doing that, and I think I will eventually because that's one of my most viewed videos, and you guys really seem to enjoy it, so I think that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to do What's in My Bag and the football gear video. So I also love like watching those videos. Like those are my favorite videos to watch at sometimes. So watching like other people's football gear. So for me to make one to like, for you to you people to enjoy, it's just really awesome. And I love making the video, just putting all my gear together and showing you guys. Where will LeBron go next season? So LeBron actually just signed, already didn't sign, but he's accepting a 4-year, $137 million deal with the Lakers, something like that. But he's going to Lakers, so it's pretty exciting. And I'll be watching some Laker games this year to see LeBron. I'm wondering if he's gonna wear 23 or 6. I'm not sure, but we'll see. And I'll see how he. I'm wondering how he'll like, you know, work with Lonzo, and maybe Kawhi will go there. It's not really decided yet, but you know, we'll see. What do you recommend throwing a tighter spiral? I don't think I'm the best person for that question, but what I always focus on is when you throw, just finish with your fingers. Like, just throw it with your fingers and finish in this position. You know, if I throw a ball, like at the camps I did, if I threw a bad spiral, I would just, after that, just kind of like focus on over the top finish and finishing with the fingers down and hit and a coming off my, these two fingers last. And usually that helps me with the next throw. Do you see yourself playing college football anymore? I do see myself playing college football, you know, if I work hard enough. But I don't really see myself anywhere specifically. Hopefully somewhere that has good academics. What is your favorite football cleat you have used? You know, I don't really know because every football cleat I have, I think it's the best. Like, I had, which ones did I have? I had these Under Armour ones in 7th grade. They were really nice. I had Under Armour Spotlights in 8th grade. Last year, I had Under Armour Highlights. This year, I've added Zero 5.0, so I've kind of, you know, gone on the spectrum. I do think Under Armour have some very good cleats, and I do think Adidas has some really good cleats, so it just kind of depends. I don't really have a personal favorite, but maybe I'll find that favorite. When did you first start playing football? I started playing football in the 3rd grade. I believe I was 8 years old. So my max throwing distance, I really haven't measured this a lot because I don't feel like me trying to throw as far as I can is very healthy for my throwing arm. But I did at a camp this year throw 50, which I know isn't like spectacular or anything. But that is just the max I've ever thrown. I don't really feel like going out to the field and just going 55 and just trying to chuck it. I feel like that's unhealthy for my arm, but the max I've thrown is 50, I believe, during camp this summer. My ultimate goal for football is to play in college, you know, get a great education, and still play the game I love for 4 or 5 more years. I think that would be the perfect thing. And I'm not really into playing in the NFL, not really big into that, but I would love to play football and then maybe coach it after, you know, college and stuff like that. Is it hard to memorize your school's playbook and is it big? My playbook last year was 33 plays and they were just, a lot of them were the same plays, but they were just flipped or a little bit of a variation. So it really wasn't that hard. I don't really have a problem with memorizing playbooks, but I know a lot of schools have a lot of plays in playbook, but mine was only 33, so it was pretty easy to memorize. Do you have a Vices now? Yes, boys, I got a Vices. I'm so happy with it. Show it to you guys right now. I love this thing. This thing is so comfortable. Haven't taken any hits with it. I'm not gonna do that until, you know, practice, because I don't wanna artificially hit myself. But yes, I do have a Vices. Man, do I love this helmet. It's so comfortable. From what I've been wearing it. I'm gonna put it on right now. Just ignore the hat hair. But we're gonna put this baby on. I haven't fully, you know, adjusted the chin strap, so the chin strap is a little off. I might have to order a new one. Sports Star, if you're out there, hit me up. I would love to get a new chin strap. But yeah, the Vices is great. Love the Sports Star collab. Love the Oakley collab. I'm getting the Prism visor soon. It's going to be coming in the mail in a couple of weeks. But I'm really excited. This is the first time I've had a normal chin strap. I had a Riedel Speedflex for 2 years and then a Zenith for 1 year. So I haven't had like a normal chin strap in a while. But this thing is so comfortable. I would kind of compare it to a Zenith. The Zeniths, the pads were super soft when you put them on. The Speedflex were kind of like stiff. But the Speedflex are actually really comfortable. So this one has really soft pads as I put it on. Not a lot of pains. There's a little pain up here, but I think it's I can just adjust pads. But man, this thing is awesome. Put my number 16 on here. I don't know if I'll be 16 this year, but I just had, you know, my number on my old Speedflex. So I was like, well, I'll just put it on my new Zenith. But this thing is amazing. And it's kind of hard to get off for me, but I love it so far. And I'll definitely make a review on it. And I put this green gridiron. Gridiron sent me these American flag decals a while back. I actually couldn't find them. They were lost for a little bit. But now I put them on there. So I'll be repping that for the rest of the year. And it really fits well with the gray Vices right there, the silver Vices. Got the standard two-bar face mask. See if that can focus. Two-bar face mask. It's one that Alex Smith wears. I think it's basic, it's got really good vision. This thing, peripheral vision is insane. Usually Speedflex, like, you could probably see till here, but here it's moved back with the angled side view. Amazing, love this helmet so much. And the technology in this is insane. I'm not gonna talk about it too much because I want you guys to learn about that in the review, so I can go in depth. But man, the technology on here, you just wouldn't think about putting in a helmet, but you can tell this technology really, really works and that it just is very thought out and a ton of research went into this. So I'm excited to wear it for the season, get a review done, and show you guys how much I love this helmet. So Hannah Schindler asked, shout out to Hannah Schindler, what is the point of wearing the leggings? I get this question a lot, usually from ladies, you know, why you wear leggings. Leggings to me, you know, they have that swag factor to it, and also they have like, they keep you like cool in a way, but like also not like, like they keep you cool, but not like cold or whatever. Like they keep your legs warm so they're ready to go, but they don't make them like hot. So like it's a good mixture of like, and they're comfortable too. So like keeps your muscles warm without being making them like really hot. Like you see those baseball players with those big jackets on. I don't like to wear those. I like to wear the, you know, leggings, and they're also, you know, comfortable, keeps your muscles warm, and they have that swag factor to it. And if you're playing on a turf field, you're not gonna rip your knees up, and that's why I'll be wearing some tights for a few games this year. What is the most TDs you scored in one game? What is the most touchdowns you scored in a game? The most touchdowns I scored in a game is 3, 2 passing and 1 rushing. That was my best game. Very fun game. And yeah, we got the dub that game. How long have you been a quarterback? I've been a quarterback for, next season will be my 4th season being a quarterback. Started being a quarterback in 7th grade and never looked back since. Always knew it was my favorite position and the one that I was destined to be, but the coaches before me didn't think I would be a good quarterback, but my 7th grade coach did think I would be, did, believed in me to be a quarterback, and that's how it started. And that's going to do it for this video. I've been filming for about 20 minutes now answering you guys' questions, so hopefully this video will be great. Hopefully I answered your question. If I didn't, follow my Instagram at quarterbackHD and submit your Summer Grind HD videos. I'll give you a shout out, post it on my Instagram, and yeah, catch you guys in the next video. Quarterback HD, signing off.
Peace.